lot of the times a smaller person, smaller opponent working against a larger opponent has the problem of a couple of different things. You'll see a lot of people trying to shoot in and so forth, and one thing, they shoot in from too far away. That's an easy way to get compressed where you're on the bottom of the pile. Another thing is when you're working in the clinch range and you try working towards access to the back and so forth, the upper body comes in prior to the legs working. What that tends to do is if any time that the head is over the hips like this, that means I can redirect pretty well, or I can get to a point where I compress her. So even if I just, if I were to sprawl out, but even if I didn't want to sprawl, if I just wanted to take her head and just bury her by collapsing on top of her, even if she got a leg, she's still under my weight, unless she knows how to, you know, like wrestling, spin out and do the sit-out drill and so forth to get to the outside. And not everybody's very skilled in that, especially if you're a shorter person, smaller person against a larger person. So one of the things we have to look at when we're doing any type of engagement and she wants to get into the inside is she has to get the feet in first. So that movement is really important. Now, her control on the upper body allows her to start passing so that her body can come in. When she gets to the point, if she tries to just move her feet in like that, it can work, but you've got to do this side shift. So if I'm trying to come in like this, one of the things that I will sometimes work to get the hips in like this, because I'm setting up for throws and that sort of thing. And it's really hard, unless somebody's just doing a hip check, to pull you out like that. But that's why we have elbows. So when this is in here, I can use that arm against the bicep and start working my hip in. So anytime you're tied up and you're just trying to get your hips in like this and she hip checks you, you take your elbow just forward pressure and outward. And it's not just out here, but it's also back. And the reason that is because if I just go out like this, she'll be able to still circumvent this by going under. So I go here and forward, that means she still has to get around the elbow in order to make this work. If she's trying to do that on me, and she's just trying to come on in, she's trying to get that, and I put the hip check in there, she bumps that. Now, that entire time though, you're gonna work that, getting that movement of the hip in with a purpose. So my movement in here, like this, when I'm actually setting this up, I'm working to get either this arm, I'm working to get the head, or I'm working to get the upper body, but I'm trying to shift here so that eventually I'll get to here so I can perform that throw or a sweep or whatever else I'm looking to do, or I can just drop back into the and take the leg on the roll. On her end, she has to have that purpose for the hip. So if she's coming in like this and she's working that movement, yeah, see, that's where it was. Yeah, so so think about that, which isn't impossible. If you're going like this and I'm setting up like this, I can do this, but I have to have my upper body in play. If I'm bent like this, it's not affecting you at all. Yeah, and you're set up for this. So if I come in like this, I have to have my body straight. I'm posturing this way so that your leg is now compressing, and I'm actually doing this, hooking on the, yeah, I can hook on the collarbone if I want to be mean. I can just grab the trapezius. I can grab the jaw, whatever else, anything along that line to help bring this back so that her base is compromised. Because then I can start, I can do tons of different stuff. I can go back into silat at that point. I can work any type of pick and lift if I need to. I can drop down through there, take the leg. There's arm compressions that I can do from here. I can go from this position I'm taking at this. I can just hook the arm, drop her back as I kick the leg out. That's why I didn't do it, is because it's kind of a nasty drop. But now it's controlled, so it's easier to see. So if I'm working this and I bend forward, there's nothing stopping her from doing that. We're like this and I do the hip check, she bumps that out. Boom, there we go, now she's in. Now she's compromising my base, making it so that I have to start adjusting properly. So she's basically hooking here, but she can hook up over on my shoulder like that. There we go. And right away, you can see that the difference is dramatic. So she's trying to get in with the hip. I'm doing this. She bumps out with the hip check. This is what she did. It works really well. So the hip check, what she did on there was she just extended her hips back and then brought them back in. And doing that, she also used this to clear. So boom, she used her arm to come through, clear, stepped in, got the hips in forward. And as soon as she started the high line hook, now it's a simple pull back and it's not a problem as you saw me going down. So as you come forward, I hip check, just elbow, and you're in. There you go. Wherever I happen to be, if she comes in, I'm gonna hip check to bring her so she can't come in more. She does that. Yep, and there, that movement off of the hip is just a very short little burst with the elbow. Pop, yeah. And then she's gotta just circumvent my body so she can hook up on that high line. Now see how low you're going? Just bring your hips in more, straighten up, there you go. That's it. So that's where you're gonna lose some of your power if you stay down like that. So I'm up here, I'm compressing, I'm gonna make sure you can't get anywhere. There we go, that's it. So it actually works really well. So even if we're just in the clinch and I'm doing the hip check like this, there you go, elbow in and that's it. One more time. Getting in, that's it. Yes, there. See, and it only works if you're not bent forward where you're not extending to a better base. Use your height. So that's the main thing that we have to look at is use your height in these matters. So again, she's in here, we're clinch, whatever she's trying to do that, I hip check, mm-hmm. She just bumps it out.
This one, I feel like this one's better.
Oh, yeah, maybe not, because okay. We're closer now. So if you try to do the hip out, what happens is I've got enough space here because of how close, it won't come off easily. So the elbow is still the best because as you take this off with the elbow, we'll leave this clear for a second, as soon as that is cleared, the hip comes in. There's no hesitation at that point. And then it's a matter of, we're in here like this, bumps that, she's in there. Now, just keep your height. Yep, there you go. That allows you to make this work better. So if you're rounded out, see, that gives me an ability to come forward, meaning to stabilize my base and force against what you're doing. So keep that, arch me all along the pathway. So, yep, and then you gotta get that upper body. So all of our stuff, whenever we're doing a pickup and lift, we're arching like this. We're making sure that we're getting the hips in, but also arching back like that. And that's what she has to do, because what she's gonna do is she's gonna curve my body against the backward curvature of her own. So we're in like this, I stop, hips, there we go. Yep, and now upper body more. See, get your height. See, you compress too low. Yep, when you're there, yeah. So immediately stick out your belly, there you go, automatically. Just her straightening her posture forces me into a worse position. I have to use my core a lot more, and it's nothing for her to sweep out the leg. So it's really, really important that if you're gonna get to that outside, I hip check, boom, like that, own your height, keep your height. Ride me along this curvature of your body, kick the leg out like that, boom, good.
I'm in a weird,
yeah, just a knee bump to, there you go. That's it. Yeah, you were already there. Now, if we do this and she gets to the inside, you can clear that if you want. You'll just, yeah, skim it there, but step to the inside. So now clear it, step to the inside. Well, well, as you can see, it worked pretty well. So again, we're up on a high line. She clears and does a pretty good job. Again, this surface is really sweet for flying like that, because the leaves underneath gives me no traction and makes it really difficult. So she'll do that again. We're in this position and she's just gonna clear that. She's gonna do a little bump. All I'm gonna do is, yeah, and she's in. So I'm gonna work that control, but she's gonna bump it enough to where she clears, yep, steps in. Yes, there you go. Because she doesn't want to compress her base longer than that, or shorter than that. So if she comes in, clears that pop, then comes in, but she's all compressed like this, I'll be able to compress her down further. Just by the mere fact of bumping my legs, I'm gonna start working a top tackle or top control.
Tips on footwork for that?
So mine is a step and slide. That's all. So I'm gonna clear that, just like that. Then I'm gonna go in a little bit further. Pop, yep. And you can do it in two steps. So you can get that initial landing and then the adjustment step, okay? So one is clear the largest amount of distance, and then the second is float me on the hips. It works really well. So that's it.
Yep.
Yeah, so think of that. One is that large step in to clear the most distance, and then the second is an adjustment step if needed. Okay, so again, all right. That's it, and that's, yeah. So now it's just a matter of getting hip placement a little better to make it a better throw. Okay, so we're up like this. There you go. Yep, and the adjust.
I didn't get low enough.
Yeah, there we go. Ha ha, clear that one, yes. There we go. Now try to get the hips in a little deeper. That's all right, there you go. That's it. Now she's floating. If she can float, or the person can float you, then you know they can throw you. It's an easy step after that. Okay? Any questions, please put them in the comments below. And please check out CoreJKD.com for our articles that I'm writing. Please thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't. Thank you.